Yo, what's poppin', everybody? Welcome back to the Boulevard now. Today, I know my camera doesn't look, you know, as clean, but y'all seen this quality before. If y'all actually have been on my other channels, this is the old webcam that I used to use. I'm using a different one because the one that I usually would use is right here. This is the one I would usually use, you know what I'm saying, for live streaming and stuff like that. Which I need to pull up real quick. You know, I need to just, you know, fix some stuff. Yeah. Really would use usually, but yeah. Story time. I got a story for y'all. Basically, I'm about to tell y'all the story of how I got my first ever girlfriend. Now, the story may be short, because it wasn't really as much for me to get her. There's just a backstory to it, and then it leads to the actual story. I don't know how the breakup went, but I'll just tell the story. Anyway, so we're gonna call, I had this crush, right? We're gonna call her Melinda. Nah, that's too. Nah, I need something with some sauce on it. Hella. Kylie. We're gonna call her Kylie. I had this crush on a girl. Her name was Kylie. Also, this is like sixth grade. Crush on a girl. Her name was Kylie. You know. Sixth grade. Nah, I'm saying this is my first time ever meeting her. There's like the school system that we had. We had like freaking 12 elementary schools with only 3 middle schools. So like when you were in sixth grade, you met like so much new people, but I didn't really know anybody in the school like that. Also, this is sixth grade. Also, the year of my depression started. I'm not going to hop into that too much. But, you know, this is sixth grade. But also, still kind of pretty happy. Started sixth grade. And then I go into my second period. And, you know, we're doing the group projects and stuff like that. And that's when I seen Kylie. But you already know, when you are a kid, when a girl is pretty enough, mind you immediately like them. That's just roll call. That is literally just roll call. When a girl looks pretty, bruh, hey. Hey. Hey, but I saw Kylie. Kylie was this bad looking chick in the sixth grade. I'm saying this in the sixth grade because for y'all people in the car, I saw Kylie, bad chick, right? And she's just sitting over there. In my mind, I was like, she doesn't look like she belongs in this grade. But okay, she wore this like black and white striped sweater that she wore like every day almost. It was weird. All right, it was weird. But like it took to like the third day of school when we were doing our first group project. You know what I'm saying? Alright, so, we're doing a group project. Everybody can, you know, choose their group. You know what I'm saying? Everybody know. You can choose their group. So I was like, me being the Matt Daddy in sixth grade, you already know. I was like,
are you stupid or something?
You already know. I slid over there, and it was like everybody was on the ground. It looked like I was already, you already know. See, the computer turned off over here. That's why I panicked because, you know, I'm doing a video right here, but you know, I'm looking at myself over there at the same time, you know, monitoring myself. But she was over there with one of my good friends at the time that I knew since kindergarten. And she was working with her. They knew each other. I didn't know they knew each other, but they knew each other. So I slid over there, you know, having a conversation. Now she had a little bit of social anxiety, and I'm not telling you, this is not me. This is me telling you I do have social anxiety to the max. It's just that, you know, when I like a girl, you know. See, me, back then, I kind of want to be that person. Because I was fearless. I literally slid up and I was like, yo, I like you. Be mine. Like, I can't do that now. Like, the confidence I have back then, dog, was unparalleled. But anyways, I slide over there, right? We're talking, we hit it up. We're also doing schoolwork at the same time. But we talk, we hit it up. And then it's lunchtime. So I'm like, well, this is the third day, you already know. Might as well, you already know, sit by her in the lunchroom, and you already know, it's middle school. If you sit by a girl consecutively every day at lunch, y'all pretty much banging, bro. No cap. That's all in the kid's head. So, I go up to her. And I go into lunchtime, we already know, we talking about stuff, you know, conversating back to forth. And then, fast forward to like 5 days later after that, we're learning about the Holocaust. Yes, we learned about the Holocaust in the sixth grade. I think they just put me in like all honors classes and didn't tell me. I don't know. But we're talking about the Holocaust. And then I was like, you know what? You know, I want to talk to you out of school. I want to speak to you out of school. You know what I'm saying? So I walked up to the desk right beside her, and we were talking, conversating back and forth, you already know, passing notes. And then I was like, so girl, how about that number? Bro, when yo! I told bro, how about that number? Bro, I slide the note over to her, right? And she actually gives me her number, bro. Nice. So you already know, we're spamming W's in my head right now. WWW. I'm literally dancing right now. You know what I'm saying? In my head. She don't see it, but I'm dancing right now in her head. In my head. We didn't have each other's social media yet. So, nah, saying. We give each other phone numbers, you know what I'm saying? And literally, fast forward after that day, that night, I call her up, you know what I'm saying? And we talking, conversation on the phone, we playing Truth or Dare. My brother shows up. He's playing Truth or Dare with us. He's being weird. We kicking it on the phone, you know what I'm saying? Fast forward a month later, I meet her friend. Let's call her friend Leah. I meet her friend Leah. Now, me and Leah have been, we've talked before, but, you know, we really haven't, you know, talked before. So, you know, that's when I started to pick up with her more. So, you already know, you know, when you want to get to the girl, when you want to get to the female, you got to get through the friends, the best friends first. That's basically what that situation was. I was going through the best friends and the friends first. So when I went through all that, you know, we became pretty good friends. Now, me and Leah were already texting at the time, and then we was like, all right. We was talking about Kaylee. Now, and she was like, man, I wish I had somebody to look at me like how you look at Kaylee. And then I was like,
do it!
Bruh.
Do it!
Would I tell you?
Let your dreams be dreams. Yesterday, you said tomorrow. So just
bro.
Do it! Make your dreams come true!
From liking Kaylee to Leah, bro, in 0.3 seconds, bro. In 0.3 seconds, bro.
Nothing is impossible.
Now, mind you, Kaylee has gone through boyfriend after boyfriend after boyfriend. And I've been trying. You know what I'm saying? I've been trying. Leah steps up to the plate.
Do it! Yes, you can.
And you already know.
Just do it.
Those instincts came early. My hormones DLC has officially been installed. So I say to her, well, I wasn't going to tell you, but I had a little crush on you, you know what I'm saying? And you... preteen females are dumb. So they go and they hop in. I'm sorry for me for my thing going out again. Preteen teenagers are dumb. So, you know, she wanted to hop in the run. She goes in anyways. So what we do is, she was like, well, I had a crush on you too. And then me, I never had a girlfriend. I've never asked out anybody. I had nobody asking me out before. So I was like, in my mind, I was like, is this your way of asking me out? And this is all through a text. I was at my father's house with my sister at the time. I've also gotten a mate before my actual sister. My sister didn't get a boyfriend until after I had a girlfriend. And actually, after I had multiple girlfriends. And my sister's older than me, by the way. So if you're watching this video, Anyway, she steps out the plate. She says, I like you. And I said, I like you too. And then I was like, so are we going out now? She was like, yeah. And I was like, oh! Oh! Stop! W. I was like, Dub. Dub season. Dub or you. And then, after that, bro, we was together. To be mindful, half of this story was me liking Kaylee. I didn't talk to Leah but for a month. And we didn't even talk like that. And then I got in those very quickly. That's crazy. That's wild. But after that, we dated for a little bit. We eventually broke up right after, but we got back together because you already know I had nobody else to go to. And she was the only one there, you know what I'm saying? But, bro, my first girlfriend wasn't even the girl that I liked intentionally. No, I dated Kaylee in the 7th grade. I finally got her to like me. And I dated her in the 7th grade. Not once, but twice. I had her twice. And that's a proud moment in my life. I'm sorry. That's just a proud moment in my life. I had her not once, but two times. People can't even say that. Anyways, that's the story time of how I got my first girlfriend. I hope y'all liked it, you know what I'm saying? I told you more content coming soon. Also hope that you just watched the Lil Uzi versus the World 2. Add a review. I told you if y'all want a part 2, 5 likes, spam them in the comments. But if you want more story times, you already know, like this video up, spam them in the comments. And yeah, I'll pretty much see y'all later. Deuces.